Good evening, everyone. It's time to call to order this March 5th, 2019 meeting of the Gallatin City Council. We'll begin this meeting, as we do each meeting, with the pledge and the invocation. Councilman Alexander is going to offer our prayer this evening, and Councilman Fan will lead us in the pledge. If you'll stand with me, please.
Let every heart pray. Eternal gracious God, once again, we come with thanksgiving in our hearts. We thank you for this beautiful day that has created. We thank you for this council and this city and all that it stands for. Now, Lord, we pray that thou be in the midst of this service, that everything we say, everything we do, be pleasing in your sight. In Jesus' name I do pray, and every heart said, amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Ms. Kittrell, if you'd call the roll for us, please.
Vice Mayor Camp.
Present.
Mr. Alexander.
Present.
Mr. Fan.
Present.
Mr. Fennell.
Here.
Mr. Hayes.
Present.
Ms. Love.
Here.
And Mr. Overton.
Present.
We have a quorum, Mayor.
Thank you. We have no minutes provided this evening, so we'll move on to public recognition on agenda-related items. This is the time of the meeting where, if you're here tonight and you have an issue on the agenda that's of concern to you, you may come forward and address it at this time. We ask that you introduce yourself, share your address with us, and then you'll have 5 minutes to speak. So, and there is a period at the end of the meeting for public recognition on non-agenda related items, so you may speak to anything that's not on the agenda at the end of the meeting. But right now, public recognition on agenda related items is now open. You may come forward. And I see no one indicating that they wish to speak, so we will declare public recognition on agenda-related items closed. Moving now onto Mayor's comments, and I just have a few things. I want y'all to know that Chuck Stewart's birthday is tomorrow, although he is in Louisiana with his mom and maybe with Mardi Gras. So.
Maybe. Swapping around.
He's still in New Orleans. On Thursday, there's a Red Cross blood drive happening at the Civic Center. That's from 1 p.m. until 6 p.m. I want to remind this council and others who may be interested that this Friday night, the Gallatin Shalom Zone Tribute Dinner is happening. That's at Hendersonville Baptist Church. I know that several council members have made reservations. If you still would like to, just let us know. And then this Saturday is the Gallatin Shamrock Run, which benefits the Gallatin Chamber Foundation. It registers at 6:30. I think the run starts at 7 or 7:30. It's always fun. You never know if you're going to get sunshine or snow.
By the way, Mayor, they need some more volunteers to help. So
they need some more volunteers. If you'd like to,
we'd love to help.
Help a great cause and have some fun and dress in green, here's your opportunity this Saturday. That will conclude Mayor's comments at this time, moving us now into the regular agenda. Item number one is public hearing on ordinance 01902-4, and Councilman Hayes, you're recognized.
Yeah, this is an ordinance of the City of Gallatin, Tennessee, rezoning two lots totaling 6.98 acres from the General Office District to the Mixed Use District with a preliminary master development plan for Avondale Farms located south of Nashville Pike and east of Chute Lane, authorizing the revision to be indicated on the official zoning atlas, repealing conflicting ordinances, providing for severability, and providing for an effective date. It's a public hearing.
Public hearing on ordinance 01902-4 is now open. You may come forward if you wish to speak. See no one, so we will declare public hearing on ordinance 01902-4 closed. And item number two is public hearing on amended ordinance 01902-6. Councilman Overton.
Thank you, Mayor. This ordinance, City of Gallatin, Sumner County, Tennessee, approving a preliminary master development plan for the Shops at Payne on 1.722 acres, located on tax map 126P, Group A, parcel 021-00, located at the southwest corner of intersection of Nashville Pike and Davis Drive. Authorizing revisions to be indicated on official zoning atlas, repealing conflict of ordinance, providing for severability, and providing for an effective date. This is a public hearing.
Public hearing on amended ordinance 01902-6 is now open. You may come forward at this time if you wish to speak. I see no one indicating that they wish to speak, so I'll say that public hearing on amended ordinance 01902-6 is closed. Moving on to item number three, which is second reading on ordinance 01902-3. Councilman Alexander.
Thank you, Mayor. This is an appropriating fund in the amount of $70,000 for radio infrastructure generators and building. Second, and I so move.
Motion by Councilman Alexander, second by Councilwoman Love. Is there any discussion? Okay, this is second reading on ordinance 01902-3. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, please say no. Does pass unanimously. Item number four is a first reading on ordinance 01903-7. Councilman Fennell.
Thank you, Mayor. This is an ordinance appropriating $604.17 for revenue received from insurance for damage of the Pierce fire engine. I so move.
Motion by Councilman Fennell, second by Councilman Alexander. Is there any discussion? This is a first reading on ordinance 01903-7. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say no. Does pass unanimously. Item five is first reading on ordinance 01903-8. Councilman Fan.
This is an ordinance appropriating $6,193.32 from revenue received from insurance for damage to the fire mobile. I so move.
Motion by Councilman Fan, second by Councilman Alexander. Is there any discussion? Okay, first reading, 01903-8. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say no. Does pass unanimously. Item six is first reading on ordinance 01903-9. Vice Mayor Camp.
Thank you, Mayor. This is an ordinance appropriating $79,229.92 back to the fire department salaries and benefits. So moved.
Second.
Motion by Vice Mayor Camp, second by Councilman Overton. Is there any discussion on this? Okay, I did check with finance on this because usually it's absorbed by the departments, particularly the larger departments when this happens, but they said that they were supportive of this because it was such a large amount, and you know, if there's any left over in the salaries budget, it comes back to the city anyway. So no further discussion. This is first reading on ordinance 01903-9. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed say no. Does pass unanimously. Item number seven is first reading on ordinance 01903-10. Councilman Hayes.
This is an ordinance appropriating funds in an amount of $100,000 for furniture and equipment for fire station number five. Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion by Councilman Hayes, second by Councilman Alexander. Is there any discussion on this?
Mayor, I guess this is a question. Chief, will you come up just a second, please? Chief, have we checked with anybody have we ordered new furniture? Is that what this is? We ordered new furniture? What are we doing with this?
We're ordering new furniture for some areas, and we're also working with Nashville and with the warehouse, and we're looking for used furniture that's lightly used, that's in good shape, like for a conference table if we can get one. We went down there today. They did not have one for us. Mm. We looked at office furniture, and they didn't really have anything for us, but we did leave our contact information. We were at the Andrew Jackson Building in Nashville today trying to get some furniture, but we're also aware that we need to buy recliners and couches and those type of things that they're not going to have in the office furniture setting.
How soon do we need this furniture?
Well, we're going to need this furniture in the next 5 to 6 weeks. So we need to order it because we don't know what the turnaround time is going to be on getting it. So that was the reason of bringing the ordinance for it last week. So it gives us time to get it approved and get it ordered.
Okay. Can I ask a question?
Mm-hmm.
I thought last week that the $100,000 that we budgeted for the furniture, we had to use that money for a change order for the building.
We
so
did.
Now we're... Okay.
We're replacing
them. Which is why he's asking for it.
I understand.
I had not expected it to be asked for, but it's the will of this council what we do.
The only thing that I'm kind of unclear of is if we do have a change order, was you aware of that, Mayor?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the change order, but I didn't know that we were going to ask for more money for furniture.
Okay.
So.
The only reason why we are, because we already had it there in the first place, but because of the change order, we had to use that money for that.
Well, I understand, but typically, it's kind of similar to the last that we passed. We would expect it to be absorbed in other places. You know, I think engineering ran into it with their facility and had to cut their purchases, and we didn't allocate them any additional money. And so,
We didn't have any other places that could absorb it. We had a solid $2.5 million, and in that we had the allowances, and they've been used up, and it was nowhere else for us to get that money under that contract price. It was nowhere else for us to get it. Everything that we had in allowance is pretty much used, and it was nowhere else for us to get the money, so we had to come and ask for it.
When you say furniture, I would presume that's also bedding?
The beds are part of the contract price, so we will get beds. We are probably going to get the mattresses as well. This is more of office furniture, couches, recliners,
TVs,
pots, pans, dining room table, chairs, that kind of stuff.
Can
that's not covered.
Would you provide us for an inventory? With an inventory before second reading of what it is you're purchasing?
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. We're already working on that. What's with purchasing, and we have a list that we're putting together for JR as we speak.
What's
but
your,
yes, we can.
Because I would love
that.
To at least save some money on it.
Mm-hmm.
That's not $100,000 at the very least.
It sounds like you're doing the right thing, going and checking to see if there's anything that's
we're trying
able to
and
be purchased that was used. So
yes,
that's
ma'am.
Good.
We're trying, and it is not our intent to spend $100,000, but we started with $104,000 with $75,000 on the allowance, and then we did value engineering, which we saved another $29,000, and we put all that on that same line item, and we've roughly spent now about $98,000 of what we had. So reason we asked for $100,000 to get the funding back that we had, and we're going to do our best to be as fiscally responsible as possible as we're making these purchases. But we do need furniture, and we need pots, and we need tables and lamps and all those things for the fire station, so.
Are you bidding that out local?
Yes, sir. Some of the bigger items will be bid. We'll follow the city's policies to make sure that we bid those things out that have to be bid. Some of the smaller things we're able to just to purchase, and we will be doing that at a competitive rate as well, looking to see to get the best deal that we can on the things we need.
Anyone else? Okay, this is first reading on ordinance 01903-10. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say no. Does pass unanimously. That concludes the regular agenda, and it brings us now to other business. Does anyone on this council have other business to bring forward?
I guess we would be remiss if we didn't acknowledge that on the 7th of this month be our mayor's birthday too. So
yeah.
Go by her office
yeah.
and get chicken and cake.
Or you could have extended some grace and ignored it. So thank you, John Dick. He likes it with bones though. So.
Make your hair grow.
Miss Love, you have a chicken eating buddy over here, Miss Alexander. Anyone else?
I heard
that. I did not. What was it? All right. Is there any public recognition this evening on non-agenda related items? A reminder that this is the time of the meeting. You can come forward to speak to anything that's on your mind, and we'd welcome you to do that at this time. Okay, seeing no one, I'll declare public recognition on non-agenda related items closed. And with that, I would entertain a motion to adjourn by Councilman Overton, second by Councilman Alexander. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
We are adjourned. Everyone have a lovely evening. Be safe going home. We look forward to seeing you here again next time.